Hi friends, welcome back. Our today's topic is percentage. As we know, percentage is one of the very important topic for all kind of government competitive exams, let it be bank, SSC, railway, UPSC, CSAT and placement trainings. In all the exams, question from percentage will be there. And percentage becomes one of the important topic because there are many topics in quantitative aptitude which involves percentage. Examples are data interpretation, profit and loss. So this kind of topics involves percentage a lot. So let's understand the question and try to solve. So this question is very important, and this kind of question has been asked in exams many times. In an election between two candidates, one got 55% of the total valid votes. 20% of the votes were invalid. So there were 20% votes which were invalid. So what is the total number of vote? If the total number of votes was 7500. So whatever information has given, first we will write it down. So total number of votes is 7500, right? Okay. Now you see 25% of the votes were invalid. This is second line. So if 20% of the votes were invalid, then how many votes were valid? 80% votes were valid, right? Okay. So if you calculate the number of valid votes, then 7500 into 80 by 100, right? Because 80% of the votes were valid. So this we can simplify it, 00 and 00. So 75 into 80, I will not multiply it here. If it is required, I will multiply at the end. If I multiply here, it will become complicated, right? Okay. So 75 into 80 is the total number of, 7500 is the total number of vote, and 75 into 80 is number of valid votes, right? Okay. So by this line is clear, total number of valid votes, this I have noted down here, and valid votes also we have calculated here, right? Okay. Now what is the next line? In an election between two candidates, one got 55% of the total valid votes. So in the election, there were two person were there, suppose first person and second person. So one person is getting 55% of the vote. Then how much second person will get? 100 minus 55, which is nothing but 45% of vote second person will get, right? Okay. So in an election between two candidates, one got 55% of the total valid votes and second 45%. 20% of the votes were invalid. If there were total number of valid votes was 7500, what is the number of valid votes that the other candidate got? So other candidate got 45% votes, right? Okay. So valid votes was how much? 75 into 80 were valid votes, and one candidate got 55% of the valid votes, then the other candidate will get 45% of the valid votes. Now this, if you simplify, you will be able to get the answer 24 times and 25 times, and this will be 15 times. So 15 into 4 is 60, 60 into 45. Now 5 into 6 is 30, 3 will be in hand. 4 into 6 is 24 plus 3 is 27. So 2700 will be the number of votes other candidate will get, which is nothing but 45% of the total valid votes. So what will be my answer? So for this question, option B will be the correct answer. Let's see question number 2 and try to understand here. Sumit got 30% of the maximum marks in an examination and failed by 10 marks. However, Sujit, who took the same examination, got 40% of the total marks and got 15 marks more than the passing marks. What were the passing marks in the examination? So this is also a very important question, and this kind of questions will be repeatedly asked in the examination. So maximum marks is not given. So let's assume the maximum marks is X. Okay. Now Sumit got 30% of the maximum marks. So Sumit is getting what? 30% of the maximum marks. So maximum marks is X. So Sumit is getting X into 30 by 100, and failed by 10 marks. So after getting 30% of the maximum mark, Sumit is still failed by 10 marks. That means if Sumit would have got 10 marks plus 30%, then he would have passed. See, Sumit is failing because of 10 marks. So if I'll add 10 marks, then Sumit will what? Pass. So I can say the passing marks is 30% plus 10 marks, right? So till here, the first statement is clear, right? Okay. Now what is the second statement? Sujit, who took the same examination, got 40% of the total marks. So this is Sumit. And if we'll talk about Sujit, then Sujit is getting 40% of the maximum marks, right? And got 15 marks more than passing marks. So if we'll talk about this, this is having 15 marks extra than passing marks. So if I will subtract 15, then this will be equal to passing marks, right? Okay. Now see, this is also passing marks and this is also passing marks. Both we will equate. So x into 30 by 100 plus 10 will be equal to x into 40 by 100 minus 15. Now x, I will bring it this side. So x into 40 by 100 minus x into 30 by 100 and 10 plus 15 will become what? 25, right? X by 100 you take common, then 40 minus 30 will be what? 10 is equals to 25. So x by 100 into 10 is equals to 25. 1010 cancel, the value of x will be what? 250. So x is what? X we have assumed the maximum marks. What they're asking in the question, what were the passing marks in the examination? So in any equation, see, I have two equations, one is here and one is here. So in any equation, if I'll put maximum marks is equal to 250, then we will be able to get the passing marks. So let's take equation number one. So 250 into 30 by 100 plus 10 will be my passing marks. See, 1010 cancel, 1010 cancel. So 25 into 3 is 75, 75 plus 10 is equal to 85. That means 85 marks was the passing marks, and in this case option D will be the correct answer. So I hope you understood the question and the solution. Thanks a lot for watching the video.